Good evening everyone. Today we are going to discuss about computer numerical control machine. First we will see the evolution of NC machines. In the 1940s they found the NC machines. First initially it is used to manufacture the aeroplane wings, especially in the aerofoil shapes, and also it is used for first only in the military purposes. Then afterwards it comes into the domestic purposes and used to manufacture the automobile component. Then in 1970s computers come into the market. It is used to manufacture, sorry, computer comes into the market, computer it will be introduced into the NC machine, that is called as CNC machines. So usually what is CNC machines? Computers are used to control the numerical control machine tool, then the machine is called CNC machines. In other words, use of computer control the machine tools like lathe, milling, as well as shaping, drilling is called CNC machines. Already we people are knowing that what is a machine tool device. So machine tool is the tool is embedded with the machine itself, means that is called it as machine tool devices. The next, the cutting operation performed in the CNC machine is called CNC machining. In CNC machining, first program was written as well as it is fed into the CNC machine. According to the program, CNC control the motion and the speed of the machine tools. Then this is the CNC machines. So here they will be showing, this is the three jaw chuck as well as this is the tool holder. Here that coolant has supply over all in the operations. So and then comes into the and this the dashboard, it can be used to move the tool nearer to the workpiece. First, once it will be moved nearer to the workpiece, then we'll close the door and the according to the program, this CNC machines works, and then we'll get the required shape. So, then comes into the next one, the major components of CNC machines. There are three major components of the CNC machines are there. One will be the input devices, and second one will be the machine control unit, and third one is the machine tool devices. So input devices is also called as programmed instructions. So first we'll see the input devices. These are the devices which used to input the part program in the CNC machines. So this involves the step by step commands which is fed into the system, and also part program is written and that will be fed into the systems over with the help of the input devices. And here there are three type of input devices which can be used: punched tape reader, magnetic tape reader and computer. Usually the punched tape reader and magnetic tape reader used for in the NC machines, and computers used for in the CNC machines, which can be used to store the more number of programs over here in the CNC machines. Then comes into the next one, the machine control unit. So usually it is the heart of the CNC machines. It perform all the controlling actions of the CNC machines. So usually the feed, speed, depth of cut and movement of the tool, everything it can be controlled by the machine control unit. And also the main function of the machine control unit is that to convert the high level language into the low level language. So high level language is the whatever program we written over there, that is we can call it as high level language. And machines, it can be understand only the machine level language, that is the zeros and ones. So okay, so that is low level language. So the machine control unit, first it converts the high level language into the low level language, and also it reads the instruction and fed into it, and it decodes the coded instruction, and it will be helps the movement of the tool. It may be a linear movement or circular movement, like this it will be helps to move the tools over here. Okay. And it receives a feedback signal according to the speed of the drive, it may be changed over here. and also whenever it required the coolant, and when we switch on the spindle speed on off, everything it has to be controlled over with the help of the machine control unit. Then comes into the next one, the machine tool device. So that is the output. Now we can say that actually the machining has to be takes place in the machine tool device. A CNC machine is tool always has a slide table and spindle to control the position and speed. The machine table controlled X and Y axis direction, and the spindle is controlled in the Z axis direction. So usually that work table has to be moved into the XY direction, and spindle it moves in the Z directions. And also the machining, the required shape, we can get it with the help of this machine tool devices. Then comes into the driving systems. The driving systems of a CNC machine consist of amplifier circuits and drive motors and ball lead screws. So the MCU feeds the signal and each of each axis to the amplifier, the circuit. The MCU, whatever signal it will be sends, that will be get it with the help of the amplifier circuits. And also the control signals are then augmented to actuate the drive motors, and the actuated drive motors rotate the ball lead screw to position the machine table. Actually, with the help of the lead screw, the tool post is moving nearer to the work pieces. According to that, whatever work it has to be takes place with the help of the lead screw, the operation has to be performed over in the CNC machines. Then comes into the feedback system. The system consists of transducer that act on as sensors, and it is also called as measuring system. It contains position and speed transducer that continuously monitor the position and speed of the cutting tool located at any instant. Already you people know that transducer is changing the one form of energy into the another form of energy. Okay, so here continuously is monitor the speed of the cutting tool movement. So wherever it changes anything, the feedback signal system, it will be sent to the machine control unit, sends the signal to the machine control unit. According to that, it will be act on it. Okay, and the MCU receives the signals from this transducer and uses difference between reference signals and feedback signal to generate a control signals and correcting the positions and speed errors. And display unit, a monitor is used to display the programs, commands and other useful data of CNC machines. With the help of that, we'll know that the tool movement, how it will be moved towards the work pieces. So that we can monitor with the help of the display unit. Then we'll come into the advantages of the CNC machines. So here advantages, in the sense it will be going to compare with the NC machines. Okay, so usually in the CNC machines, it produce high accuracy and it can be run for 24 hours per day, and it produces same accuracy. There is no variation in the part manufacture, and there is not required for the highly skilled operator, because here the operator can be used to fix the tool and remove the tool maximum extent it can, they can be used, and also transport the tool from machine to AGVs. So for that operator can be employed over here. And also the manufacturing lead time, it will be reduced. And also some more advantages, more number of programs we can store over with the help of computer numerical control machines, that is not possible over in the NC machines. And also here retrieval will be very easy in the CNC machines, and editing and modifying the programs also very easy over in the CNC machines. That will be not easy in the NC machines. And fewer work or required to operate the CNC, and running cost will be reduced over the help of the CNC machines. So these are all the advantages of CNC machines. Then comes into the next one, disadvantage. The cost of CNC machine, usually it will be high. The parts and CNC machines are expensive. The maintenance cost also, it will be very high, and it does not eliminate the need for costly tool. And also here it will be one more disadvantage, it will be a skilled programmer will be required. So that is also disadvantages of the CNC machines over here. Then comes into the next one, CNC motion control system, point to point control system, straight line control system, and continuous path control system. First we'll see about the point to point control system. The CNC moved along with the first tool movement, it will be moved along with the point to point motion, that is takes place here. Only the tool movement takes place in the horizontal manner or vertical manner or inclined manner, like this only it will be takes place. That means the tool movement takes place from one point to another point, straight movement it will be takes place over here. Okay. Then comes into the next one, straight line control system. So here the tool movement, it will be moves along with this like a straight line, either it may be a horizontal line or vertical line or inclined line, like this it will be moved over here. So this is called it a straight line control system. So these two movements mainly it will be used for in the milling operations, exactly in the to manufacturing of keyway cuttings as well as to producing the slots. This straight line as well as the point to point control system, which can be employed over here. Then comes into the next one, continuous path control system, or we can say that contour path control system. So here what happens, it can be provide like this shape as well as in the edges they can use curved shape. It can be produces the curved shapes also it possible over in the contouring method. So it may be a clockwise method or anti-clockwise method, both the curved position it can be created over in the this continuous path or contouring system, or contouring control system helps move the tool into the circular method. That comes into the next thing, dimensioning system. There are two types of dimensioning system is there. One is absolute coordinate system, another one is the incremental coordinate system. In the absolute coordinate system, it will be takes place with the help of common reference point. All other dimension has to be measured, means that is absolute coordinate system or absolute dimensioning system. Incremental coordinate system, taking previous point as a reference point, that is the incremental dimensioning system. For in this example, I will take this diagram. So in this one, the xy coordinates they will be given according to this one. This is 0, 0. According to this, all the dimensioning has to be measuring, or all the dimensioning has to be indicated, means that is called as absolute dimensioning system. But comes into the incremental dimensioning system, for in this point they will be going to take the reference point as a this coordinate point, and then goes to the second point like this one, the previous point, this will be act as a reference point, that is called as incremental method. It goes to the third point, this will be act as a reference point. So like this means that is called as incremental method. So it will be continuous. Usually the incremental method that can be employed for only in the complex shapes. For simpler shape they will be used for the absolute dimensioning systems. Then comes into the CNC horizontal milling machines. So it will be usually it will be look like horizontal milling machines. So here the arbor will be in the horizontal position, that's what it is called as horizontal milling machines. In the horizontal milling machines it will be used to perform the heavier jobs, mainly heavier jobs, and also the slots and keyway cuttings, everything it will be performed over with the help of this CNC horizontal machining. Machining. So this is the horizontal milling machines. So in the here the base it can be accommodate for to perform withstand the heavier components. Then comes into the vertical milling machine, since vertical milling machine, so it will be used for to manufacturing of low sized job as well as medium sized components, and also complex shapes it can be produced. CNC vertical milling machines, the arbor will be in the arbor or spindle will be in the vertical in position, so that's what it is called, it as vertical milling machines. So this is also produce the slots as well as holes and different complex shape it can be produced produce in the vertical use of CNC vertical milling machine. So this picture is showing as the vertical milling machine. So then application of CNC machines. So CNC machines usually metal removal industries it can be used, and material fabrication industries it can be used, and non-conventional machining industries where the machining task is difficult to perform manually. So those areas this can be applied, the CNC machines. And CNC drilling, CNC milling, it will be employed over here. This is about the application of CNC machines, and thank you.